Watch the Powerball drawing live tonight here on TV 23. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV 23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to High Plains Today on TV 23. Today is Wednesday, July 29th, 2015. On today's show, we will be joined by Denae Weber, and she is with Bright Futures Liberal. Now let's take a quick look at the news around the area, nation, and the world. During the second annual Dodge City Days food truck competition, food trucks from across the state gathered to serve signature dishes of their unique style to the public. Now, the competition was part of the International Park Festival in Wright Park on Sunday, hosted by the Dodge City Area Chamber of Commerce Multicultural Committee. The food trucks that took part in the competition were Tacos El Pastor, Brick House Barbecue, and two lemonade and shaved ice stands, Bahama Mamas and Summer Freeze. The food truck wars were decided by public vote. Each truck made a $2 signature plate as part of the competition. Brick House Barbecue was declared the winner, with second place going to Tacos El Pastor and third place to Summer Freeze. The City of Garden City pitched a change to its neighborhood revitalization program to the Garden City USD 457 Board of Education on Monday, hoping the board would agree to the change. Now, which city officials say could bring more tax money into the school district. Carol Davidson, Garden City's Assistant Planning and Community Development Director, said the district could draw from a larger tax base by removing limits on the program that allows homeowner and business owners to receive tax rebates renovating their property, as long as the property doesn't exceed the current maximum. And while it's only in the discussion phase at this point, the Garden City Recreation Commission is considering a proposal to develop an indoor futsal facility on the east side of town. At the Garden City Rec Committee's board meeting Monday, John Washington, Superintendent of Recreation, pitched the idea to board members. Now, futsal is a modified form of soccer played with five players per side on a smaller, typically indoor field. The Village at the Plaza in Liberal has welcomed its first residents as the first building is complete, and the second will be ready for occupants shortly. Now, the project, which began construction late in 2014, will be completed in the early fall. The Village at the Plaza is a market-rate 48-unit apartment complex located in the plaza at 1220 North New York. The complex includes 32 two-bedroom apartments and 16 one-bedroom apartments. A Minnesota dentist who went on a guided bow hunting trip for big game in Zimbabwe said that he had no idea the lion he killed was protected and that he relied on the expertise of his local guides to ensure the hunt was legal. Walter Palmer, who has a felony record in the U.S. related to a shooting a black bear in Wisconsin, released a statement Tuesday after Zimbabwean authorities identified him as the American involved in the July hunt. Secretary of State John Kerry warned skeptical lawmakers not to nix the contentious nuclear deal with Iran, insisting that it includes strict inspections and other safeguards to deter cheating by Tehran. If Congress does not support the deal, we will see the deal die with no other options. Now, that's what Kerry told the House Foreign Affairs Committee on Tuesday as he testified for the second time in a week. This is part of the Obama administration's all-out campaign to sell the accord. And Texas authorities on Tuesday released several hours of footage showing Sandra Bland during her 3 days in jail, saying they wanted to dispel rumors that she was dead before arriving there. Waller County Judge Trey Duhon said such conspiracy theories, including one that Bland's mugshot was taken after her death, had prompted death threats against county officials. And the Senate will vote before its August recess on a Republican effort to block federal aid to Planned Parenthood. Now, Democrats say they will strongly oppose what they called the latest Republican effort to weaken women's health care programs, but stopped short of flatly predicting its defeat. The positioning came as an anti-abortion group released a third covertly recorded video of Planned Parenthood officials discussing procedures for obtaining tissue from aborted fetuses. That's a look at just some of the things that are happening around the area, nation, and the world. Stick around. We'll be right back with weather right after this.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell. TV 23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
You want to feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
This new family, and I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy all day long. Tap, 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 tap. Oh, and she even talks to it. She talks to that more than she talks to him. What's up, bro? Nice shirt. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
And welcome back to High Plains Today as we look to the northeast on the TV 23 tower cam. As you can see, it is mostly cloudy out there as we speak. Let's take a look at our current conditions. Yep, mostly cloudy. Temperatures at 73 degrees, relative humidity at 69. Winds are out of the east at 4, and the barometric pressure is on the rise. As we take a look at the current temps around the area, you can see everybody is in the mid to lower 70s, except for Perryton, which is the hot spot at 79 degrees. Medicine Lodge at 75. Looking at the current dew points, everybody in the lower 50s to mid 60s, except for Medicine Lodge. They had those showers just go through there not too long ago, as moving from Medicine Lodge up through Wichita as we speak. Looking at the current wind temperatures, mainly everything out of the east. Few exceptions, east, northeast, or out of the southeast. But everything basically out of the east, Dodge City having the highest winds right now at 22. Looking at our almanac yesterday, it was a high of 86 degrees. The record, 104 back in 1980. The low last night, 70 degrees. Record low of 52 set back in 2005. And you can see our year-to-date rains, we're still closing in on that 18-inch mark. Looking at our forecast for today, 84 degrees, very, very comfortable. Winds are going to be out of the northeast at about 11 miles an hour. There is still a 30% chance of thunderstorms hanging around. And then tonight that bumps up to about 40%. Lows will be 65. Winds will be out of the north at 8. And they'll be dying down to pretty much next to nothing. For tomorrow, still chance of thunderstorms hanging around, 30% chance. High is going to be 86. Winds will still remain out of the east at 8. And then tomorrow night, yep, still a chance. It's not a big chance, but still 30% chance, 65 degrees. Wind still out of the southeast at 9. Looking at the 7-day forecast, as you can see, highs are going to be in the mid to upper 80s through the rest of the week. We get into the weekend, highs are going to start bumping up into the 90s. Sunshine on Sunday and Monday. Lows for the 7 days, pretty much going to be in the mid to upper 60s. That's a look at our weather. We'll be back with markets right after this. Hi, I'm Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs at noon weekdays right here on TV 23. Hey, do you think you have an idea for something that would make a great segment? Somebody that would make a great interview? What about a community event that needs highlighting? Let us know here at the station. Email us, news@kdgltv.com. This is the place. Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV 23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays here on TV 23.
Know what?
What?
Since I got adopted, I've learned a lot about these humans.
I know. I mean, check out these two. It's Flirt City over here.
Yeah, I noticed that. It looks like my human is definitely into your human.
Oh, look! I think she's getting his number.
Nice.
Your human's got some sweet moves.
Takes after his dog. Oh, look, they're doing that thing where they put their arms around each other.
She kicked up a leg. It's like in the movies.
That's awesome. Looks like we're going to be hanging out a little bit more.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 88. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
So, I just moved in with his family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake. So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door.
you know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide and go seek.
And as I'm adjusting my glasses, welcome back to High Plains Today. I am now joined by Denae Weber. She is here representing Bright Futures Liberal. Hi.
Good morning.
How are you today?
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'm doing well.
Well, in some time zones, it's still morning.
Yeah, very true.
Okay. How are things?
Doing good. Okay. I'm getting ready to go back to work here in August.
And that's right, because you work at USD 480. You're not with USD 40,
yes.
But you're and when you're not doing that, you are helping Bright Futures Liberal.
Correct.
Okay, give me a quick little 101 on Bright Futures.
Okay, Bright Futures is funded by donations, and we're going on our fourth year, and we are inside the schools, elementary through high school, and so we use faith-based partners, community partners, all sorts of partners.
Okay.
And so they are assigned to each school, and so they help out primarily, you know, within that school.
Okay, so you guys are basically a nonprofit
organization,
mm-hmm. and you provide things such as?
School supplies, clothing, bicycles, sheets, hygiene products, you know, anything from, you know, bedding, clothing, hygiene products, school supplies, backpacks, anything to that nature. And even, you know, if someone's in need and needs assistance, they usually find some way to provide those things for them.
Okay. So being in the schools in Liberal, you guys have a way of, if somebody sees that a student or a child has a need or a family has a need,
mm-hmm.
to convey that to Bright Futures, and then you guys can step in and help because you basically have anonymous donations, right?
Correct. So at the school, we have a representative. Mm-hmm. So the teacher, staff, faculty, they will go to the parent. They will go to the representative and fill out a form, that representative, and then turn it into Bright Futures. And so it'll list everything that they need and, you know, just a quick who they are, sizes, anything to that matter.
I can imagine, you know, a lot during the winter months and since, you know, we're not kidding ourselves, I mean, because Liberal has a very transient population,
mm-hmm.
you have a lot of people coming in and going all year round, and when mm-hmm. we get some of these new students in,
mm-hmm.
that they get to this part of the world and they have nothing.
Correct. And I've witnessed that at the high school is, you know, you have students coming in from warmer areas,
mm-hmm.
and so they don't have coats, they don't have jackets, they don't have sweatshirts. And so I will, you know, Bright Futures will help, and
mm-hmm.
I also will ask people for donations, and if they have all those things, even gloves, scarves, hats, anything to that matter. So if you would like to donate those things, you can donate them to me and Bright Futures. So.
Okay. Now, you guys have a big fundraiser thing that you do every year before school starts called mm-hmm. Stuff the Bus. Is that right?
Correct.
Okay. So how does that work?
Okay. So we have buses set up at Walgreens, Walmart, Dillon's, Spencer Brown's, Southern Office Supply, and Chrysler Corner. And so what you can do is you can purchase those school supplies
mm-hmm.
and the items needed and put them in the bus out the front of those stores. And so we will have lists that we will be passing out or even close to the bus. So with more of those items that we need more of. And so, you know, we get a lot of glue, a lot of scissors, a lot of these things, and those are great, but some of the things that we ran into last year were we needed more dividers, more the notebook dividers, and so more of those kind of things,
and
calculators.
Backpacks and that kind of stuff?
Yes.
Okay.
So we get a a lot of glue, a lot of pencils, which is still great. But those those dividers are really good for those secondary kids just to stay organized and on top of things.
And it's going to be kind of hard to miss because there's a big yellow school bus sitting out there in front of all these businesses.
Correct.
And if I'm I remember right, there's a big banner on them that usually says "Stuff the Bus," right?
Yes.
So you can't miss those. If you're in Liberal or any of the surrounding communities and you're going to be there and you see one of those big yellow buses, go by. Now, they got a lot of glue. They got a lot of scissors. So any other kind of school supplies,
it'll list it all out. So another thing, I think I forgot, Spencer Brown's also will have a bus.
Oh, yeah.
So I want to make sure.
Well, yeah, that way you can get a cup of coffee and or an iced something.
Very true.
Yeah.
Or even lunch. So... anyway, but if you are interested in donating or want to volunteer, you can contact Keeley Moree at 655-5764.
Okay.
So
now we'll try and get that phone number on the website when we post this on YouTube, and we'll put it on our website that they can get a hold of Keeley in Liberal. And if you want to volunteer or help out.
Yes.
I mean, volunteers are always needed.
Correct, because we are a volunteer basis. It is all nonprofit, funded by donations, so we need volunteers.
Okay.
So now, labor, any kind of products or items.
Okay, so Bright Futures has been in Liberal about, 4 years now, I think?
Going on 4 years.
Okay, and this program all got started back after the Joplin tornado, 5 or 6 years ago. And they found this need, and they started this organization. And I think, I don't know how many of these Bright Future chapters they've got spread around the country, but there are, last I knew, there were close to 30. So, I mean, it's a really good organization to get tied up with. Mm-hmm. So, one more time, give them that phone number,
655-5764.
And you can talk to Keeley.
Keeley. Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, so the big thing outside of, now, where do you keep all this stuff that you get? Because I'm sure you're not going to give it all away right away.
No. It's an ongoing process all throughout the year. We store it at the Educational Center in Liberal.
It's with the school district. Okay.
Uh-huh, their warehouse. Uh-huh. And so, we have it all organized. And so Lisa Hatcher, she has been great, and she is... our number one, she's the person you go to. And like I said, it's all on volunteer basis. And she's the one that makes sure it happens. Gets done.
And you guys also have a board of directors.
Correct.
So it's not just all one or you mm-hmm. and Lisa. There's a whole bunch of people that are involved. Mm-hmm. Plus these local businesses are involved, especially with, being able to park the bus out in front. Mm-hmm. I'm sure that they donate and those types of things too. All
right. Yes. So we also have a big event coming up Saturday, and it's at Ashley Furniture with KSCB, the Treasure Chest. And so they can come out between 11:30 and 1:30, and you can get the keys to unlock their chest. And so it's $1 a key, and all the profits raised will go straight to Bright Futures.
So you can win stuff.
Yes.
So get to Ashley Furniture. It's down there on South Kansas in Liberal.
And $1,000.
$1,000, holy crap.
Shopping spree at Ashley Furniture.
All right.
So, Denae, anyway.
Thanks for coming in
today. You're welcome. I've enjoyed
it. Bright Futures. Cool deal. All right. Stick around. Mm-hmm. We're going to be back right after this.
You want to feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen... we're here, your local TV and radio broadcasters, America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Those dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community with experts and other caregivers to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terrycloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. Totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah. That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
And welcome back. Let's take a look at a couple of things that are happening around in sports. Now, the Liberal Rattlers under 13 baseball team, they're on their way to Boonville, Missouri, and they're going to compete in a regional tournament. Now, they begin pool play tomorrow to hopefully advance to bracket play on Sunday. And Eric Hosmer's homer with two outs in the ninth inning lifted the Kansas City Royals to a 2-1 victory on Tuesday night over the Cleveland Indians, who now have lost eight straight at home. Now, that's their longest home losing streak in 40 years. And the commissioner pointed to concealed evidence. The team described it as a folly, and the agent added sham to the lexicon of Deflategate. Then the players' union said it would take it all to court. Now, Tom Brady's four-game suspension for his role in using underinflated footballs during the AFC Championship game was upheld yesterday by Commissioner Roger Goodell. Oh, man, that's one of those things you just wish would go away, Deflategate. There's a lot more things going on in the world than Deflategate. All right, let's take a quick look at our current temperatures outside. It is currently 74 degrees. Relative humidity is 69 with all that cloud cover and the moisture rolling in. That's why it's up there. Wind is out of the east at 4. Barometric pressure is on the rise. Looking at our 7-day, as you can see, we've got a 40% chance of thunderstorms today, 30 tomorrow, and on Friday, Saturday dropping down to 20. Sunday and Monday are going to be nice and sunny. Chance of storms moving back in on Tuesday. Highs are going to be mainly in the mid-80s to lower 90s. Go out and make it a very good day. And if you want to see us on your local cable, call your local cable provider. We'll see you back tomorrow. Oh, Larry Phillips joins us tomorrow.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV23 on our Facebook page, KDGL TV.